Let's get a little bit more precise with a few more add-ons. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. Just before we go any further into Blender and really start to explore the 3D space, I just want to share with you a couple more Blender precision add-ons. The first add-on is MeasureIt. I have shown you how to measure things within Blender. However, MeasureIt has something that we're looking for. It has parametric measuring. So this is, again, within Blender, we're going to go preferences and the add-ons, and we're going to look up MeasureIt, turn it on. And what this gives you is inside of view, you have MeasureIt tools. Just collapsing things down. So we're going to go into edit mode by hitting tab. And we're on vertex select, so that's number one. I'm just zooming in. And what MeasureIt has is brilliant, especially if you come from a CAD-based modeling. So we're going to select two vertices here, and we wanted to know the distance of here. This. We know that the measure tool works in the sense that you can click and then hold down control, and we'll snap to there. And we know that's exactly 10 millimeters. However, when we go and do any edits, it disappears. However, with these two vertices now selected, we're going to hit segment. Now you won't see anything because we have to turn on the show. Here, you can see very faintly some text. That's because by default, it's set to blue. So let's go and change this here. This is our new little measurement that's been added. So just to show you, if I delete this here, the measurement is gone. And if I go in segment, it's back. So let's change this. Let's make it a nice bright yellow. Let's go into this little cog, scroll down. Let's change the font size. Let me just move this out. The font size up a bit. Let's center align it. And there you have it. Now, if I go and make any more, again, it's going to come in blue and small text. So let's sort that out. So here it has a configuration. This configuration lets you change the text color. So let's go for a nice bright cyan, and let's go for center align, a nice large text of, let's say, 34. Now we can go very easily and add some more vertices here. Come on, select them and select these two, and goodness, let's go for this one too. And now we go and segment. You can see right here, it has given us our vertices. Now, there's a problem here. Everything's in meters. I'm sure those keen eyes have seen that there's units. And these units can be changed to anything you want, even to millimeters. And not only that, but there's a precision value. So you can move this all the way up to 5 decimal places. So that's all the precision, really, that you need to know. So I'm going to put this down to 3 for now. But the main reason why I like MeasureIt is this. We go into the edit which we are in, select the vertices, G, X, and now when I move things, it parametrically gives me a ruler that moves with my model. Unfortunately, I can't click into this and set a dimension, but it's the best we're going to get within this right this minute. Having said that, our next add-on lets you do something along those lines. Just before we jump into that, I want to just show you once again, you can close them here. Keep in mind that there's also an angle version. So for angle, we select one vertex, select another vertex, and select another one, hit angle. That gives you your angle here, and just quickly showing you that it's parametric once again. There is your angle. So let's undo that quickly. And let's just go up here and hide everything. The add-on I'm speaking of that lets you do that movement of vertices by a little box is something called Exact Edit. It's still a work in progress, and it does have quite a few bugs in my opinion, but for two things and two very strong reasons, I feel it fits in great, a little niche for us CAD-based modelers. So here, you're going to go into your edit preferences, Hit install. The link is down in the description to the blog post to get the most recent download link. Usually you have to just scroll down to see the most recent link. So here, once you install it, it will come in as ExactEdit. Turn it on. This gives you a little tools tab here on the right-hand side. And now within edit mode, let's stay in the top view. Now within edit mode, I'm going to select these two vertices. Now we know that we can move this by hitting G, constraining it to the X, and move it out by, it looks like this is a minus X, so let's go minus 0.45, and we have that. We know we can do that. However, what ExactEdit lets us do is if we hit set measure, now this is why I'm saying that this still needs some work. There's some very small text up here. There's some text that's been hidden by this move operation. So let me just move this out the way. So select our vertices once again, hit set measure. Very small text up here and very small text down there. This will be sorted out by the dev as I'm currently trying to get in contact with him to tell him to just sort this out because it would be great to have. But it gives you this little green dot. This is called the freeform dot. So we're going to freeform place it here. And now this red one is our anchor point. So I'm going to put the anchor point over here. And it gives us this box. So we've got 11.74, which is the exact dimension that this is set to. I want this to be exactly 10 once again. So I'm going to click in there, set this to 10, and there you have it. That, for me, is brilliant. Now, one other thing that ExactEdit does really great is scaling to the length of one edge. To do this, we're going to select everything. We're going to hit the set measure once again, and be aware that when you place this freeform, so I'm going to place it down here and place that anchor down there, this little text up here says move and scale. It's quite hard to see, and this will get fixed, I'm sure of it, but we're wanting to move this down to scale. Now, the reason why is if this is 10 millimeters, and let's say we knew that this edge was supposed to be, I don't know, exactly 25 millimeters. And this comes in quite handy, especially when you're importing SVGs or DXFs and things like that. You're able to just change this very quickly by knowing the length of one edge. So we're going to go here. I'm going to set this to 25, hit OK, and that has scaled our entire object by this one edge without having to deal with anything else, which in Blender, you actually have to do quite a few other actions to be able to do something like this. So that there is the best of ExactEdit. So I'm going to hit escape to get out of it. I'm going to undo a couple of times to get us back to where we were. So last but not least, I need to cover the very basics of something called origins. So I'm going to go into the 3D pivoting here. So I'm using the middle mouse button and the shift to move around. And you might have seen this orange dot just floating about the place. Going into object mode, you can see that everything has this orange dot. And when you move things in object mode, this little dot moves along with you. Now, if you go into edit mode, you will see that when we select everything and move it, the origin doesn't move. The best way of thinking of origin is the origin is the control point, the center of mass, the pivot point of an object. So right this minute, the easiest way to show this is if I select this, hit R for rotation, constrain it to the X, so the line that's going up and down, you'll see that it will rotate around this point. But let's say we wanted it to rotate in the middle of this surface. So let's go and undo this. We can go right click, set origin. We can move the geometry down to the origin, which would do something like that, or undoing that. You can go right click, set origin, origin to geometry. And There it is. The origin point is up to the geometry. Now I'm going to hit rotate once again, constrain it to the Z, and you can see it now rotates along that point. Now, the reason why I'm telling you this is because the next two add-ons work with the origin point. Now, we're going to select everything, right-click, set origin, origin to geometry. So now you can see all the origin points have been set to the geometry. So let's first start with align. So the alignment tool is one that is within Blender. If you go into preferences and we look in align, align tools, turn that one on. And this is underneath our item settings. There is now a new little one called align tools. Align tools is very similar to maybe Inkscape or Illustrator of aligning objects. So we're going to select everything. And just something that I want you to keep in mind is this active object. So right this minute, as you see, this has a brighter highlight than all the rest. If we were to select this one, you can see it now has a bright highlight here. So it's whichever is the last object selected is set to the active object. Just letting you see that. So fantastic. So let's go and I'm going to select this one, shift select, shift select, shift select. So our purple one here is the active object. And the reason why I'm saying this is because all these little settings and operations are talking about this origin point. So we're going to align the y-axis, so this green axis. So these will come down and this one will come up. So we're going to align the location y-axis. And there you have it. That is now aligned everything to the y-axis. You can obviously, this can be done to all. So it's plop them all on top of each other. Let's undo that. You can do this by the Z as well. So now everything is nice and flat. So just keep in mind, the align tool is very powerful. So last but not least, there's a little bit more of an obscure tool that you might be looking for, which is how would you go about doing this alignment move, but having things evenly distributed. So the only way I've been able to find to do this is within preferences, there's this add-on called Oscurart Tools. And what this does is it gives us a new option. So I'm just going to select this one, hit G, and move it out to the distance a bit. And then I'm going to go and shift select all the rest that I want. Or I could have just selected all of these and then shift select one. And now what I'm going to do is hit space, put in distribute objects and distribute them. I'm going to say in all axes, hit OK. And now it's distributed my objects here. Now the reason why it's done that is because the selection order was a little bit off. So I'm going to undo that. And this time around, I'm going to select this one first, then select that one, then select this one, then select that one. And now when I go and distribute my objects, you'll see that it does it like this. So the order of selection matters. So one more example, let's go ahead and select this one, this one, this one, and this one. I want them to stay on the Z flat plane here, but I want them to go out towards the X. So let's go and do that one more time, distribute objects. So ignore the Z axis. And there you have it. That's it being distributed. Last but definitely not least is probably one of my most used add-ons. And this is CAD Transforms. It's installed like all the add-ons that come outside of Blender. So the link is down in the description to install it. You install it and you activate it. Keep in mind that there's a lot of settings here to go through. And definitely take a look at font size and font color to make the workflow a little bit easier. Now, to show you how this works, I think I'm first going to show you the hard point. And the hard point is, for instance, if we wanted to get all these stacked on this vertex here with that vertex up there, it would be quite hard. We currently have vertex snapping on. So let's go and do a G. Hold down control and that will snap. Oh, and we got lucky, it snapped on the right vertex. So now go G, hold down control. It's no longer snapping on the right vertex. And that's the main problem we get with Blender. And if we did want that to snap on the right vertex, we would have to go inside of edit mode, select everything, turn this into the active vertex. So that's done by unselecting it and reselecting it so it's white. And now when we go into G to move everything, I didn't select everything, then you would see I would have to go into our snapping. Oh wait, I'm making a real dog's ear out of this. Into our snapping, turn it into active snapping. So then when we go into everything, unselect that, reselect it, and then we go and do that, you would see that it would snap properly then. However, this add-on fixes all of that. So undoing all these moves a couple of times, let's go and show off this add-on. So to show off this add-on, it works a little bit differently. It doesn't have a tool shelf option, so to speak. The way you do it is by turning it on. So you click it, and this now gives you this. Inside of the tool shelf, there is an active tool, and all of these here are the snapping options. Now, if you want to know a lot more about this add-on, which I really think you should, you can go into the card right this minute that has my most recent video covering this exact add-on and just how powerful it is. But I'm just going to show you it the very basics right now. So we have vertex snapping, which means now as we have it enabled, when we hit G, nothing's going to move. This is because it's asking where you're going to be moving it from. So the origin of the movement. So right this minute, because we have vertex, I'm going to select the vertex. And that means we're moving from that vertex. And because we have vertex currently selected, it's going to snap to any other vertex. I could hit E and this would turn on edge. And then that way it's going to snap to edges too. But let's turn off E and just keep it with vertex for now. If you want to know more, go and check out that video. So now we can just quickly just select all of these, hit G, select the vertex we're wanting to move, and go onwards like that. Now, one other thing about this great add-on is all of these moves work in edit mode as well. So it's very close to exact edit, but it doesn't have a text box. So if we selected everything we're wanting to move here, turn on the add-on once again, select the vertex we're wanting to move after we hit G, of course. So make sure that I've selected our vertices, hit G, nothing's going to move. I select the vertex where we're doing the origin of our movement, and we can constrain it on the X. We have this lovely little measuring tape. However, let's say I wanted to go 1.4 millimeters, I hit enter, and that's it done. So that's how this works in conjunction, and it's by far one of the add-ons that I used the most. And those there are just a few more of my must-have Blender precision add-ons. Now, I really encourage you to play about with them. See where they break, see where they work within your workflow, and if they don't work, get rid of them. I also encourage you to go and check out the wiki pages. The links will be down in the description. And really, just go to town. Sometimes you have to find that one niche time that you're stuck with something, and that's when that add-on comes into use. So it doesn't mean that you have to always have it there, and it doesn't mean you always have to use it. But when it's there, it makes your life so much easier. A big thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome, and I love your support so incredibly much. And if you're enjoying this course, I would love it if you'd support me there too. Thanks for watching. Keep making, and let the quest continue.